the new Keto-Friendly South Beach Diet. Rev up your metabolism and improve your health with the latest science of weight loss. Read by the author, Arthur Agatston, MD. Written by Dr. Agatston and Judy Wolger, MD. Disclaimer: this book discusses the author's personal experiences, views, observations, opinions, and beliefs about the diet, and may not reflect the experience or results that you will have on the diet. The author of this book does not dispense medical advice or prescribe the use of any technique as a form of treatment for physical, emotional, or medical problems without the advice of a physician, either directly or indirectly. The intent of the author is only to offer information of a general nature to help you in your quest for a better health. In the event you use any of the information in this book for yourself, the author and the publisher assume no responsibility for your actions. Before we begin, I want to be sure that you have downloaded and saved the supplemental PDF that came with this audiobook. It contains meal plans, recipes, a foods to enjoy list, and the resources I used in writing this book. I will be referring to the PDF throughout this audiobook, so be sure to keep it handy as you listen. Introduction. Dear reader, almost 20 years ago, the South Beach Diet helped revolutionize the nutrition world with a plan that focused on good carbs, good fats, and healthy proteins. It helped people lose belly fat first, while improving their health and encouraging habits to prevent diabetes and heart attacks. The science behind the diet was solid, and its principles have stood the test of time. But nutrition and medical science have continued to progress rapidly. In our clinical practice, my colleagues and I have integrated new information into our diet strategy with great success. While we have learned a great deal, there are still many nutrition myths that persist in the popular culture and even in much of the medical community. The list of those myths is pretty long, but let me tease you with a few advances that you'll learn about in this book. Insulin resistance is the core nutritional problem in America and the world today. It starts many years before it is usually diagnosed. For many of us, addiction to sugar appears to be a major factor in the development of insulin resistance. Sugar, particularly its fructose component, is akin to a slow-acting poison in the quantities we are consuming today. The dangerous consequences of our excess sugar and refined carbohydrate diets begin years before our blood sugars become abnormal, a stage I have come to call pre-prediabetes. During this period of pre-prediabetes, you are likely to already be developing a fatty liver and atherosclerosis in your arteries, but you don't know it because the symptoms have not yet appeared. Animal and plant saturated fats do not have adverse effects on your cholesterol levels, nor do they increase your risk of a heart attack or stroke. Dairy fat is healthy fat. Omega-6 vegetable oils in the quantities consumed by Americans are not healthy fats, even when not hydrogenated. Omega-3 fish oils are important for good health, and we will make sure you learn how to reap their benefits. In America, protein consumption decreases with age, contributing to loss of muscle and bone mass. This, in turn, leads to physical limitations associated with aging. This can be prevented by maintaining a healthy protein intake along with regular exercise. Intermittent fasting can be a useful tool to break sugar addiction, jumpstart your diet when you transgress, or hit a plateau and maintain a healthy lifestyle long term. Low sodium, salt, diets are unhealthy for some people, and it is important to know how your own body responds to salt. Fruits and vegetables should not be lumped together in nutrition recommendations. Many fruits are high in fructose and can be diet busters. Full ketosis can be an effective way to lose weight and reverse diabetes, but this strategy should be initiated under a doctor's supervision. A keto-friendly approach is effective, sustainable, and preferable for most people. This book, The Updated Keto-Friendly South Beach Diet, is based on the same core South Beach diet principles enhanced with the latest nutrition advances. While some of the science is complicated, the plan itself is simple. I'm excited to share this book with you because this new approach gives you the benefits of a keto diet in a lifestyle-friendly way. With its flexibility and highly satisfying foods, the keto-friendly South Beach diet is easy to start and easy to stick to over time. You will lose weight, get healthier, and feel better, and these principles will become an easy-to-maintain lifestyle. I wish you the best of luck on your journey to good health. Part 1. Understanding the Keto-Friendly South Beach Diet. Chapter 1. The Story of the South Beach Diet. What if I told you that there's a good chance you are addicted to sugar? And I don't mean that you just can't resist a nice slice of chocolate cake when it's put in front of you. I mean truly physiologically addicted to the point where you're sneaking snacks behind your family's back. At least, that was the case with me, and it led me to gain weight while supposedly on my own diet. And sugar addiction was only half the story. This revelation about sugar addiction started me on a journey that led to some surprising discoveries and aha moments that helped connect the dots on important new advances in the science of weight loss. I incorporated these into my own diet and then that of my patients. The result was a new diet plan that focuses on more efficient fat burning in an easier-to-stick-to plan, among other things, all summarized here in the new Keto-Friendly South Beach Diet. But first, the story of the series of events that led me here. The South Beach Diet. You may know me as a doctor who created the South Beach Diet, a book published in 2003 during the era of the low-carb Atkins and the low-fat Ornish diets. But the South Beach diet was different. It wasn't simply low-carb, and it definitely wasn't low-fat. It was a diet focused on healthy carbs and healthy fats. It encouraged normal-sized portions of meat, lots of vegetables, and good fats from foods such as fish, olive oil, and nuts. The original South Beach diet was divided into three phases. The first phase required giving up sugar, bread, pasta, potatoes, baked goods, alcohol, and fruit, all foods that quickly break down into simple sugars and cause surges in blood sugar, glucose, and insulin. This initial phase was the diet's most critical. It was designed to control your insulin levels, get rid of your sugar and carbohydrate cravings, and to burn fat. It was even then what we now call very keto-friendly, and it worked. On phase one, people lost weight quickly and their belly fat was first to go. In the more lenient phase two that started 2 weeks after phase one, you gradually and selectively added low-glycemic whole grains and whole fruits into your diet, and you stayed on phase two until you reached your weight loss goal. Phase three was the maintenance phase. Because I had experienced the same cravings as many of my patients, I became the first official South Beach dieter. I had great success, but I observed something important early on. Many of our South Beach dieters wanted to stay on phase one for longer than the prescribed 2 weeks. We initially thought this was driven by a desire to continue the faster phase one weight loss. But these lovers of phase one reported that it wasn't really just about quicker weight loss. They reported that when they cut out carbohydrates, they felt wonderful. They noticed that many of their health issues, such as brain fog, migraine headaches, irritable bowel symptoms, arthritic pains, and skin conditions like acne and psoriasis, went away. This was a welcome and unexpected surprise. For many, phase two ultimately seemed like a path back to their old dietary habits, with the weight and chronic health issues returning. Confessions of an Overweight Diet Doctor. Over the next few years, I realized that I had a very similar experience. When I was on phase one of the South Beach diet, I would lose my cravings and feel fantastic. But once I moved on to phase two and added back whole grains and fruits, I would eventually cheat on my own diet. In times of stress, during holidays, or when traveling, I would inevitably consume the wrong carbs, usually something with sugar, and suddenly things would spin out of control. When I allowed myself a chocolate chip cookie, I was already an admitted chocoholic. I didn't stop at just one or two, but kept going until there weren't any left. It wasn't just grains. I also found cantaloupe to be a diet buster for me. Even though I had written extensively about insulin resistance and swings in blood sugar, I thought this behavior was due to a lack of discipline. My cravings were under control after 2 weeks on phase one, so why couldn't I eat a half a cookie? I got pretty frustrated at my poor self-control along with the return of my belly. Then, in the summer of 2018, a series of events changed my life and the trajectory of the South Beach diet. It started with an incident that was frankly not uncommon. While on vacation with my wife and two sons, I enjoyed a typical healthy family dinner of salmon and roasted broccoli. But dessert.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.